everyone, and welcome to the Beginner's Guide to Gamification, episode number 15. This is Yukai Chow, and I'm here to help you go from gamification beginner to gamification master. Today we're going to talk about the core drive, scarcity and impatience. Scarcity and impatience is the core drive that says
you want something just because you can't have it, or you can't have it right now.
So for instance, if grapes are on the table, you don't care about those grapes. But if grapes are just beyond your reach on a shelf, you're always thinking about those grapes. Are they sweet? Can I have it? When can I have it? All that good stuff. A lot of brands like to use scarcity and impatience to create a powerful launch strategy. And this is again the discovery phase of Octalysis. For instance, this is how Facebook started.
I do a lot of hospital shots, huh? Something's probably wrong with me.
When Facebook started, they utilized a heavy amount of scarcity and impatience. At the beginning, it was just for Harvard students. And then it opened up to a few Ivy League schools. And then when it opened up to UCLA, where I attended, everyone was like, oh, we can use Facebook now. So everyone signed up. So eventually, as it released to more and people got excited about it. And then when it opened up to high school students, all the college kids got pissed because they felt like that Facebook is supposed to be only for college students and not for high school kids. And when they opened up to everyone, then all the college kids and high school kids all got pissed because Facebook was supposed to just be for college students or high school kids. A lot of things like Gmail invitation codes, the mailbox app is quite a good example of scarcity and impatience. Basically, excluding people to use the app and allowing them to sign up to the private beta and all this, and people have to wait for their memberships and all that stuff, that makes people actually want to join more because it's so exclusive and you gotta wait. And so people said they were waiting every day and looking at their number and see when can they actually get their user account. We add pictures of animals. Scarcity and impatience is also one of the key techniques that social games use to monetize. So take an example of Farmville. Some people go on Farmville thinking that, hey, I will never spend real money for a game like this, right? But then, you know, we're playing and then you see this mansion that's dangled in front of your face. And you're like, well, this mansion's pretty cool. Let me see what I need to do to get it. And you're like, whoa, I need to spend 20 more hours of farming to get this mansion. That's a lot of time, right? That's a lot of farming. But wait, look, wow, I could just spend $5 and I can get this mansion immediately. $5 to save 20 hours of my time, that's a no-brainer, right? So now, again, now you're no longer spending $5 to get some pixels on your screen. You're spending money to save your time. So that's part of the power of scarcity and impatience, showing people something they want through dangling, and then give them two routes, one path, which is to pay immediately, and the second path is to get them to do a lot of what I call the desired actions.
There's orange juice, and there's apple pine juice. I'm like, what's apple pine? Is that apple juice? No. This is apple juice. Grapefruit. So like, what's apple pine? Is that a fruit that I've never seen before? So I drank it, and it turned out to be pineapple juice. Ha ha ha.
Another way to implement scarcity and impatience into a design process is to add throttles into something. Basically slowing people down, stopping people from doing what they're supposed to be doing or what they want to do. But a lot of games out there have things like energy, you know, Farmville saying, hey, you can't play, you have to stop here, right, and come back 5 hours later. And because these games force people to stop, right, whether it's you have to recharge your energy, you have to wait for your crops to come out, or you have to wait for your HP, your life to go back to where it was. It makes people want to play more. So when it says, hey, stop playing, come back 8 hours later, what the user tends to do is they start to think about this. Like, oh, they try to log in 3 hours later, 5 hours, 7 hours later to see if they can, if time's up or not. Even if they know as a fact, oh, it hasn't been 8 hours yet. And again, that's just the power of scarcity and impatience. You're just like, oh, I want to play, because you're barred from it.
And if you just let people play to their heart's content, you know, like 3 hours, for instance, then people will finish the 3 hours and then they won't think about it anymore. They'll move on and maybe next day or 3 days later, they'll come back. But there's no scarcity in that element and people lose motivation. So what a game designer usually wants to do is, if they understand it's exactly 3 hours, then they let people play for 2 hours and 59 minutes and then say, stop, you know, you can't play the last minute of your desire. You have to wait for 8 hours or a day before you can play again. And so people will be anxious. They're like, oh, I want to play for another minute, my last minute, until they wait for 8 hours again, and then they're ready to play for another 3 hours, of course, another 2 hours and 59 minutes. Scarcity and impatience is also one of the black hat gamification techniques. So for a quick review, black hat gamification are those things that are very strong in motivation, right? It gets you to do things, but sometimes it leaves a bad taste in your mouth because you almost feel like you have no control over yourself or you have no control of the situation. And just like this case, right? Because you can't have something, you really want it. And that's not a good feeling. The constant feel of wanting something because you can't have it, right? It's not a good feeling, but it's great in motivation. And I'll talk about this in the episode, but in a game or a web app, you always want to balance your white hat and black hat gamification techniques. You want to make sure that even though you have black hat stuff to change people's behavior, you want to make them feel inspired. That's a problem that Zynga is facing right now. Zynga utilizes way too many black hat gamification techniques. And as a result, it drives great numbers at the beginning, but in the long run, it loses a lot of its steam and people want to leave the Zynga game because they lack a lot of white hat gamification techniques in it, or game design techniques. So in traditional economics theory, there's always what we call the demand curve. It's basically a graph that shows price on the y-axis and quantity on the x-axis. And basically what the demand curve says is that as your price decreases, your quantity will increase. And what you'll see also is that when the price is zero, you'll know exactly how many people will want to get the product, because everyone who wants the product will get it for free, right? So that's economics theory. But through the scarcity and patience core drive, you see that this is actually incorrect. In many industries, it's actually not a diagonal curve, it's a C curve. And what I mean by C curve is that sometimes as things get more and more expensive, more and more people want it also. So take for an example, right? I had a client who was choosing between two PR firms, one that charges $10,000 a month and the other $8,000 a month. And I told my client that I think the $8,000 a month agency is better. But my client is like, yeah, but why does the other charge $10,000 a month? There must be a reason, right? And I told my client that, hey, just because someone has balls to charge more money doesn't mean that he's better. But my client still couldn't make up his mind, so what he did is hire both of these agencies together and for 3 months and see which was better. And like I predicted, the $8,000 a month was way better and the $10,000 a month was really sucked, so he was let go. But the weird thing is, if the $10,000 a month guy charged $5,000 a month instead, he would have never even gotten the chance. There's another example from a book where the book author knows this woman who runs a jewelry store. And she was trying to get rid of a collection of turquoise pieces. And she's done everything she could do. She was upselling it, pushing it, promoting it, and she just couldn't sell them. So one day before a 3-day trip out of town, she finally wrote a note to her salesperson saying, hey, let's just get rid of these. Let's cut the price by half so we can sell them. So fortunately, the salesperson actually misread the note, and instead of cutting the price by half, she doubled the prices. And then within a couple days, all those turquoise pieces got sold. So that's an example of scarcity and impatience. Because the price is higher, people think it's more valuable, it's more scarce, and therefore they actually want it. So again, back to the C curve, right? Let's say when it's $0, 100 people want it and they'll get it. But when it's $100, maybe 1,000 people will want it, but only 100 people can afford it, and therefore you still get rid of 100 units, but you actually make a profit. So the reason why traditional economics theory doesn't really fit into the few examples I talked about is because economics always assume two things. First is that consumers are always rational, which is not always the case, right? A lot of times consumers are irrational, as we all know. And the number two is perfect information. Again, consumers don't have perfect information. They don't know what's out there. They don't know how good something is, right? They don't know their utility curve. So the only way for them to figure out how good something is based on how scarce it is and how often other people want it. So if you have a cookie jar with 10 cookies in it, people think it's not as tasty. But if it only has 2 cookies left in it, then people think, wow, this must be an amazing cookie, right? So they base their value on the scarcity of it. When it comes to scarcity and impatience,
there's one key major factor that you must always keep in mind whenever you're designing something. But I think I'll tell you what it is in another episode.
And this concludes the Beginner's Guide to Gamification, episode number 15. We'll see you guys next time.
Facebook! Ah, we can use Facebook! Ah!
Well, nah.